Mariner Program Flybys. These early NASA probes were humanity's first successful encounters with another planet. In 1962, Mariner 2 became the first spacecraft to successfully fly by another planet, and its instruments helped confirm that Venus is extremely hot and wrapped in a dense, high-pressure atmosphere. Later flybys by Mariner 5 and Mariner 10 gathered more data on Venus's cloud-covered atmosphere and helped confirm that Venus has no significant intrinsic magnetic field, instead forming an unusual induced magnetosphere as the solar wind interacts with its ionosphere. Zond 1. As part of the early Soviet planetary exploration effort, the Zond 1 probe was launched in 1964 with the goal of performing a flyby of Venus. While the spacecraft was successfully sent on its interplanetary trajectory, its systems failed one by one during the long cruise. By the time it reached Venus, Zond 1 had already fallen silent, flying past the planet as a dead probe. It represents one of the many early failures that demonstrated the immense challenge of communicating with and controlling a spacecraft over vast distances. Venera Program. This was the Soviet Union's masterpiece, a decades-long, focused campaign to conquer Venus. After numerous early failures, the Venera program achieved a staggering list of firsts. Venera 4 was the first probe to enter another planet's atmosphere and send back data. Venera 7 was the first to achieve a soft landing on another planet. Venera 9 was the first to transmit an image from the surface of another world. And the later, more advanced landers like Venera 13 and 14 took the only color panoramas from the surface and even used a drilling device to collect material from the Venusian surface. They are the only spacecraft to have ever successfully landed and operated on Venus. Pioneer Venus Project. This was America's most ambitious mission to Venus, a two-part assault on the planet's secrets. In 1978, Pioneer Venus 1, the orbiter, entered a long-term orbit using radar altimetry to build the first global topographic map of Venus, revealing major highland regions and mountain ranges hidden beneath the clouds. Just days later, Pioneer Venus 2, the multi-probe, arrived. It was a bus that released four separate atmospheric probes, which plunged into the atmosphere at different locations to provide the first simultaneous, detailed profile of its structure from top to bottom. Vega Program. A bold, dual-purpose Soviet mission. The twin Vega 1 and 2 probes first flew to Venus in 1985. On their way, they each dropped off a lander and, in a major innovation, a weather balloon that floated in the planet's upper atmosphere for 2 days, transmitting data on wind speeds and temperatures. After deploying their Venus assets, the main spacecraft used a gravity assist to continue their journey and intercept Halley's Comet, making this one of the most efficient and scientifically rich programs ever conducted. Magellan. This was NASA's definitive Venus mapper. Arriving in 1990, Magellan's sole purpose was to use its powerful synthetic aperture radar to pierce the clouds and create a detailed, high-resolution map of the entire planet. Over its 4-year mission, it mapped 98% of the Venusian surface with a level of detail that surpassed all previous efforts combined. The stunning, almost photographic quality radar maps it produced are still the foundation of our understanding of Venusian geology today. Venus Express, the European Space Agency's first mission to Venus. Arriving in 2006, Venus Express was a dedicated orbiter designed to study the planet's atmosphere in unprecedented detail. It spent 8 years observing the complex cloud dynamics, studying the super-rotating polar vortex at the South Pole, and searching for evidence of active volcanism and lightning. It provided the most complete picture of the planet's climate system to date. Akatsuki. Japan's only dedicated Venus orbiter mission, Akatsuki, is a story of incredible perseverance. After its main engine failed during its first attempt to enter orbit in 2010, the spacecraft was left drifting in space. 5 years later, mission controllers brilliantly improvised a new plan, using the craft's smaller thrusters to successfully nudge it into orbit. It studied the planet's extreme weather and atmospheric dynamics from orbit for years after its delayed arrival, until contact was lost, and the mission was formally ended in 2025. Gravity assist flybys. Venus's powerful gravity and ideal orbital position make it a perfect cosmic slingshot for missions heading to other destinations. A large and diverse fleet of spacecraft has performed gravity assist flybys of Venus, using the planet to change their speed and trajectory without using precious fuel. Missions heading to the outer solar system, like NASA's Galileo and Cassini, flew by Venus to gain the speed needed to reach Jupiter and Saturn, a technique also used by ESA's Jupiter-bound JUICE mission, which performed a Venus gravity assist flyby in August 2025. Conversely, probes heading inward, like NASA's MESSENGER and the joint ESA/JAXA BepiColombo, used Venus as a brake to help them enter orbit around Mercury. More recently, solar probes like NASA's Parker Solar Probe and ESA's Solar Orbiter have performed multiple Venus flybys to tighten their orbits and get closer to the Sun. IKAROS and Shin'en, launched with the Akatsuki orbiter, were two smaller experimental Japanese spacecraft. The most successful was IKAROS, a groundbreaking technology demonstrator whose primary goal was to test a solar sail propelled only by the pressure of sunlight. It successfully performed a flyby of Venus in 2010, proving the viability of this advanced propulsion technology. Its launch companion, the small university satellite Shin'en, was also intended to fly by Venus, but communications were lost shortly after launch, and it passed the planet silently. Future fleet. After a long hiatus, Venus is about to enter a new golden age of global exploration. A fleet of new complementary missions is planned for the early 2030s, led by NASA's Veritas and Da Vinci, which will be NASA's first Venus atmospheric entry probe since Pioneer Venus in 1978. They are joined by ESA's Envision, a powerful orbiter studying the planet's surface and atmosphere. This renewed focus is not limited to the West. Russia plans to continue its historic legacy with the ambitious Venera D mission, which aims to deploy a new long-lived lander and orbiter, while India is also joining the effort with its first Venus orbiter, Chakrayaan. Furthermore, a new paradigm is emerging with privately funded missions like the Venus Life Finder, a small probe designed specifically to search for signs of life in the planet's clouds. China has proposed Venus mission concepts in recent years. Plans have shifted over time, including discussion of a Venus atmosphere sample return concept, but firm timelines and mission details have been limited. Together, this international and commercial flotilla aims to finally answer the question of why Earth's twin turned out so differently. Thanks for watching. If you had to choose just one of these missions to send back tomorrow, which would you pick? And what would you want it to discover about Venus? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Also, please remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.